happy to be in front of your screen right now to scream loud the Lord to you, your ears tonight, in Jesus. It's a privilege to be before you, and I just grace, because it's by His grace that we are whatever we are. It's by His grace we've been called to be able ministers to Him, hallelujah, and to be His oracles, to speak His voice, to speak His mind, you know, to our time and era, praise God. So tonight, I just want us to, I welcome you on board, I welcome you to, and I would like to appeal to you to please share the video so that everyone can watch it. Say to us tonight, His church in particular, yeah, hallelujah. So before we go further, I'd just like us to pray briefly and ask the Holy Spirit to have His prayer minutes. I can't do anything without Him. Hallelujah. Sweet Spirit of God, just join me as we pray for 2 minutes. Father, we just worship You tonight. This is all about You, Lord. It's not about me, Father. I decrease that You alone, Jesus, will increase. This is about You, Lord. You be glorified in the hearts of Your people, in Your bride that You died for, that You called out of darkness and brought into Your light, into Yourself, Jesus. I ask tonight that the right mind, the right hearts, the right audience, the right people, that this message is meant for, Jesus, we catch it, we receive it, Abamosha, that it will be ministered to Karabashanda, and the desired change and transformation, desired to receive will be gotten up of peace in the name of Jesus. For Your word is forever settled in heaven, it can never be broken, it can never fail. Karabashaya, it was accomplished, the purpose went to it is sent, Jesus. You are the living word. Tonight I ask Jesus, Karabashandahaya, that by Your Spirit, oh God, by Your power, Jesus, the power of the word, Your power in Your word tonight, Karabashandahaya, will be activated in the, to bring life, to bring change, in Your bride, in Your people, in the hearts of the people and the minds of the people, that this word that You're speaking to tonight in the name of Jesus, I call, I pray for their ears, Holy Spirit. Open up their spirit in the name of Jesus. I ask that You open up their spiritual eyes, the eyes of their understanding, yes Lord, to be able to perceive and understand what You're saying tonight through this vessel in the name of Jesus. Take the glory. Let no man, let no flesh glory Your presence. Let no man take the glory but You, Jesus. You alone, the firstborn Son of God. Baruch, our Messiah, our Lord and Savior. The one who gave Himself for us. I honor You tonight. Is about You. You are the message, actually. Yes, You are the message, Jesus. Hey, help me, Holy Spirit, tonight to reveal Jesus, to reveal the message to the people, to His bride, and let Him be received. With majesty. Let Him be received with faith in the name of Jesus. Just quicken me tonight. Let all trance be given to me tonight. Help me to speak Your word, to speak Your truth. Guide me, Holy Spirit. Let me not add my words, but let me speak as You lead. Let me speak as You direct in the name of Jesus. I bind every powers of darkness, principalities on the cyberspace. Wherever that we want to intercept or interrupt this flow, this communication tonight, I subdue them by Your Spirit, by Your power in the name of Jesus. And I cast them into the lake of fire where they belong. I restrict them by divine authority. They will not function, they will not operate in the name of Jesus. Lord, I thank You, Lord, because Your word is alive, it's living and powerful. Karabaya, sharper than any two-edged sword. Tonight, Karaba, let it divide asunder. Karaba, let it descend the thoughts of Your people. And divide asunder, Karaba, Shanda, Hayada, Bosha. Every ignorance, every darkness, every dark counsel that may be in any of them tonight, and let Your life penetrate them in the name of Jesus. And let Your word as a seed be seeded in them, Jesus, and begin to grow and germinate. Karaba, Shanda, in the name of Jesus. Lord, I thank You. I just release Your blood right now in the atmosphere. Karaba, Shanda. Purify my mind, purify my mouth, Karabasha, purify the sound, every song that will be played tonight, everything that will be said, purify in the name of Jesus, purify the atmosphere right now, Karabasha, purify the cyberspace in Jesus' name, and let the atmosphere be conducive enough for Your glory to rest upon us, Father, in the name of Jesus. Thank You, God. Quicken us tonight, Holy Spirit. Quicken us, Father, in Jesus' name. Amen. Hallelujah. Glory be to Jesus. So I welcome you tonight to unpopular worship, you know. Unpopular worship is broad, is deep. If I begin to tell you what it is, it may take the whole 1 hour that we have and still will not be be enough, okay? But tonight, I would like to say to you that uncovering means the mind of God, revealing the mind of God for the now. For the now. We know God speaks every day. Yes, so what is his mind for his church for now? What is his mind for the world? What is he saying to the church? What is he saying to the government? What is he saying to everyone? So that's what unpopular worship is about. It's bringing you the word of God, bringing you the voice of God, bringing you the mind of God for the now. Hallelujah. Amen. So I want to welcome you tonight. After the word has been, will be delivered to you, we're going to, you know, go into worship. Tonight, fellowship is different because the Lord wants to speak to his church. Praise God. So I welcome you again, and I ask that you please share the video, invite your friends, you know, brothers and sisters, so everybody can partake of this and hear what the Lord, what the Spirit of God is saying to the church. Praise God. Okay, so first of all, before I start, I would like to quickly declare that I have no rights to the songs I'll be playing today, but by the Spirit of the Lord, he's asked me to play the songs, you know, to further express and explain his message, what he's trying to communicate to his body, to his church tonight. You know, one of the God speaks to me, one of my prophetic expressions is through songs. So don't be amazed why I have to play some songs for you to understand what he's saying, because some of the songs carry the message. Some of the songs carry the message, they carry the heart of God, what he wants us to hear or to know. So there are some songs he selected for us to play tonight that I'll be playing. So I just want to give credit to the owners of the songs, to the writers of the song, and to the singers of the songs, you know, and appreciate their ministry and the gift of God in their lives, and for them to be a blessing to us, you know, through music, through their ministry. And I also encourage you to please look out for those songs, listen to them, promote the songs, you know, in Jesus' name. So thank you. So one of the songs is going to, is like the one playing right now, is by GUC. It's titled Desperate, so you can look for it online. Another I'll be playing will be Desperate People by Micah Stampley. I'll be playing also what's the song now? You are my Everything by Ron Kennelly and then Dali Check. Then I'll be playing my own song by the grace of God, titled Let Your Glory Fill the Space. That song is not ready, it's not in circulation now, but it's only on the digital platforms. But I'll also be playing that because that's what the Lord is saying to us. So these are songs that convey the meaning of the message. Praise God. So thank you and God bless you. Let's go straight into the word. Yes. So this morning, the Lord began to speak to me about he gave me a scripture in 1 Peter chapter 4 verse 7. Quickly go there. You can please turn your Bibles with me if you have your Bibles. Let's quickly go there. He was speaking to me from 1 Peter chapter 4 verse 7. Just hope my voice is audible enough. Please, is the sound okay? If you can't hear me, please let me know, because I don't know. Okay. 1 Peter chapter 4 verse 7. He began to speak to me today. He says, I'm going to read the whole text as directed, but this is the key, the emphasis. He says, but the end of all things is at hand. Be ye therefore sober and watch unto God. That's what he was saying to me this morning, this evening. So I would like to read that scripture from the very first verse to the last. Hallelujah. And I just pray that you listen to it, you know, with your spiritual ears, so you can catch what the Lord is trying to say to you. It says, okay, from verse 1. For as much then as Christ has suffered for us in the flesh, arm yourselves likewise with the same mind. For he that had suffered in the flesh had ceased from sin, that he no longer should live in the flesh to the lust of men, but to the will of God. For the time past of our life may suffice us to have wrought the will of the Gentiles, when we walked in lasciviousness, lust, excess of wine, revelings, banquetings, and abominable idolatries, wherein they think it strange that ye run not with them to the same excess of riots, speaking evil of you. Who shall give account to him that is ready to judge the quick and the dead? For this cause was the gospel preached also to them that are dead, that they might be judged according to men in the flesh, but live according to God in the spirit. But the end of all things is at hand. So be ye therefore sober and watch unto prayer. Remember, that's the emphasis. Okay. Verse 8. And above all things, have fervent charity among yourselves, for charity shall cover the multitude of sins. Use hospitality one to another without grudging. As every man has received the gift, even so minister the same one to another as good stewards of the manifold grace of God. If any man speak, let him speak as the oracles of God. If any man minister, let him do it as of the ability which God hath given. That God in all things may be glorified through Jesus Christ, to whom be praise and dominion forever and ever. Amen. Hallelujah. Beloved, think it not strange concerning the fiery trial which is to try you, as though some strange thing happened to you. But rejoice, inasmuch as you are partakers of Christ's sufferings, that when his glory shall be, ye may be glad also with exceeding joy. If ye be reproached for the name of Christ, happy are ye. For the spirit of glory and of God rested upon you. On their part, he is evil spoken of, but on your part he is glorified. But let none of you suffer as a murderer, or as a thief, or as an evildoer, or as a busybody in other men's matters. Yet if any man suffer as a Christian, let him not be ashamed, but let him glorify God on this behalf. For the time is come that judgment must begin at the house of God. And if it first begin at us, what shall the end be of them that obey not the gospel of God? Take note of that as well. And if the righteous scarcely be saved, where shall the ungodly and the sinner appear? Wherefore, let them that suffer according to the will of God commit the keeping of their souls to him in well-doing, as unto a faithful creator. Praise the Lord. So this is what this is the key scripture that the Lord began to speak to me today, this morning, with. And then he began to talk to me about being desperate. You know, going to the verse 7, which is the highlight, which is the emphasis. It says, but the end of all things is at hand. Be ye therefore sober and watch unto prayer. Praise God. So he began to speak to me about desperation. That the end of all things is at hand. So it is time for his church. It is time for men and women. It is time for believers. It is time for his true church, his sons, his children, to stand on their watch, to be sober, to be vigilant, because they know the hour. And that calls for desperation. That calls for spiritual understanding. Someone who understands the times and seasons that we are in and knows that he or she has to stand. He or she has to stand on her guard. He or she has to praise the Lord, are we together? So he began to speak to me about being desperate. Being desperate for what? Being desperate for God. Being desperate for his move. Being desperate for his anointing in this season. Being desperate for his spirit, for more infilling in his church. Being desperate for his fire. Desiring the Lord above every other thing. Praise God, are we together? Okay, so I go ahead, I continue. So he began to say to me that to be desperate for something is to have an in-depth desire, hunger, longing for something. So he's saying to his church tonight that the era, because I must say to you now that we have entered spirit. Manifestations will soon begin to play out. Hallelujah. We've come into a new era in the spirit. And a lot is going on, and a lot is going to go on. And it is not the time for the church to be in slumber. It is not the time for the church to be distracted. It is not the time for the church, for you and I, to be overwhelmed by events, by social events, by culture, or things happening around us. But it's a time for us to be sober, vigilant, waiting on the Lord, patiently to hear what he has to say, to release those anointings and graces of our time, of this generation, of this new move that is about to, that he wants to release. So there's a new era we have entered. There's a new move of God that is about to shake the earth. And the church needs to be awakened. And that is the duty of the prophets, to sound the alarm, to blow the whistle and say, hey, this is what is coming at you. You better stop sleeping. The prophetic comes in to quicken the church, to alert them of either danger or of good that the Lord is about to release to them or on them. So he's saying to the church right now, it's time for the church to awake. He said the church is so distracted. A lot of them are sleeping. A lot of them are overwhelmed, chasing after money and all sorts of things. And the enemy is busy. transferring souls every day to hell, keeping men in bondage every day. He says souls are languishing and the Father is crying. He said this is a time to be desperate for souls, for soul winning, because souls are perishing every day. Every day. It's not a time to be relaxed. He said, arise and awake, all ye that be at ease. He said, this is the time to shun complacency. This is the time to be awake. If you have to be awake all night and all day, this is the time to be alert so that you can receive, so you can connect with that which the Father is doing in this time and season. So that you don't miss the moment for yourself, you don't miss the moment for your congregation, for his disciples that are under your care, for his sheep under your care. So you don't miss the moment even for your family. Hallelujah. This is the time to be alert, to be desperate for the Lord, for his presence, to say, Father, here I am. Lord, improve me. Lord, make me better. Lord, I want more of you. Lord, fill me. Release your outpouring. Fill me up with your spirit. I want more. I know that I know you, but I need more of you. I want to grow in you. I want to go deeper. God, like, there are depths in the spirit. There are depths in the Lord. You can never say you've had enough. No. There are more. In the Lord. So he's calling us to come up deeper, as is recorded in Revelation chapter 4. He's calling the church to awaken right now. Boys and girls, youth, teenagers, fathers and mothers, parents, pastors, ministers, everyone. God is, I'm sounding the alarm by the Spirit of the Lord. Like the voice crying in the wilderness. He said, arise, for a lot is about to take place, both negatively and both positively. But trust God and hallelujah. Because by the Spirit of the Lord and by the authority of Christ, advantage, and I believe we'll have the advantage. But this guy, while men slept, the enemy came and sowed tears. The enemy came and sowed tears. So this is not a time, you know, to celebrate the season and all of that. But do not be carried away by events, so that the enemy will not overrun you. Praise God. As you are eating the chicken and drinking the wine, it's going to be sensitive and it's going to be alert. Make sure you are with me. Keep your devotion with me. Be consistent. Be desperate for me. Be desperate for me. He says he's hungry for a desperate generation. He said he wants to raise a desperate generation that are desperate for him. Like he said, the world awaited the manifestation of that era. When the sons of God will begin to manifest the power of God, the glory of God, will begin to manifest Christ on the earth, begin to release Christ on the earth. When the earth will begin to be filled and be covered as water covers in the knowledge of the glory of God. This is the era. It's a new decade. It's a new century. So the Lord said, church, awake. Awake in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. So he said he's seeking and he's calling us to become desperate. That most of us are too complacent. He wants that hunger. He wants to fill us with his fire, to awaken, to quicken us. Hallelujah. Let us not be carried away by events and the happenings around us. And we miss the spirit. And we miss the moments. And we miss the moves. Say, let us be careful. Say, stand on your watch, for you know the hour. Praise God. So he says, and for you to be desperate simply means you have to separate yourself. You have to separate yourself from those things that you know are distraction to you, so you can focus on God. He said, if your eye be single, your whole body will be full of light. This is a time for our eyes to be single. What does it mean for your eyes to be single? For your gaze and your focus to be on Christ, to be on the will of God, on knowing what is happening in the spirit. So that you will not be overtaken by events. So that the enemy will not have you at a disadvantaged position. He said this is the time to stand up. So we can possess that which is about to do in this time. Hallelujah. Because he's depending on us, his church, his body, to carry out his will on the earth. To legislate his counsel on the earth. So we cannot not be sleeping. Praise God. Tell us to awake. For a hungry generation, a separate generation that is willing, that has the desire to separate themselves from the works of the flesh, from the lust that drive men to perishing. He said, awake and arise. He said, he's seeking a hungry generation. The church, it is time for you and I to be hungry. To be hungry for the more of God, for the move of God, for a revival. A lot is going on around us. And the Father is very well aware. But he wants to bring a change. But he cannot bring a change if we are sleeping. This is the time, I hear the Spirit of God say, this is the time to ensure that your lamp has oil. In Matthew chapter 25, talking about the five foolish virgins and the five wise virgins. So this is the time to be wise. Of the sons of Issachar, of understanding the times and seasons, what the Lord is doing in this era, and to be a partaker of it, not to be a spectator, not to be one that sleepeth, but one that is awake alert. Karabasha, so you don't miss the moment, you don't miss the hour. Karabasha, the ayalabosha. This is the time to be quickened by the Spirit of the Lord. This is the time we should cry out. The church needs the fire of God now more than ever. Because if we don't arise, calamity is very near. Calamity is on its way. Hey, this is the time to be hungry. Hungry for the righteousness of God, for His holiness on the earth. For the church to begin to cry for souls and begin to cry and say, repent, repent. Let every man repent of their sins, repent of every unrighteousness. This is the time. This is the time to overtake the enemy. This is the time to overrun the chariots of the enemy. By the Spirit of the Lord, the Spirit is ready, but He's calling the vessels to awake so He can pour Himself upon the vessels. So the fulfillment of Joel chapter 2, verse 28 can come to pass in our days, in our time. We have entered and stepped into that era. So the Lord is calling for sons to arise. He says, sons, arise. He said, daughters, awake from your complacence. Awake. Or pursue Him in your comfort zone. This is the time to go to the wilderness. Like David said in Psalm 42, any will I seek you, O God. As the deer pants after the water brook, so my soul longs for the Lord. In a dry and thirsty land, when will I sing? When will I appear before my God? This is the time. I say, this is the song. This should be the desire of our heart. This should be our hunger right now. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. So he began to say to me, I said, the depth of your desperation will determine the height of your revelation or your ascension. If you decide to slumber and sleep, you will stay low. But if you decide to awake and arise, ambition is spoiling your lamb, you will begin to soar like an eagle on high altitudes. Praise God. You will be so unstoppable. Karabasha, the higher. They don't say he's raising a takeover army. This is the time the church will awake. Karabasha, and begin to manifest the glory of God on the earth. The Lord says, arise. He said, for the end of all things at hand. He said, be ye sober. Stand on your watch. Be alert in the spirit. Be sensitive in the spirit. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. So I would like you to read that scripture, Psalm 42. You know, at your own. Read Matthew chapter 6, verse 22 as well. Because of time, I mean, David said in Psalm 27 verse 4, I would like to read that scripture to you. Is he talking about being desperate? Being desperate for God, for His presence, for His grace. The latter has been greater than the former. This is the time of that outpouring. But we cannot receive it when we are sleeping. We cannot receive it when we are not on our watch. We cannot receive it when our fire is not burning. We cannot receive it when our lamp lacks oil. The Lord should not be the one waiting for the church. The church should be the one waiting for God. I hear Him say in the spirit. He should not be the one waiting for. We should be waiting for Him. This is the time for every one of us to go to the waiting room and begin to seek the Lord daily, day and night. Day and night, patiently waiting for Him. Psalm 27. Psalm 27, the key verse is verse 4. It says, one thing have I desired of the Lord, that will I seek after, my God, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, to behold the beauty of the Lord. Marabaya. If you do not dwell in the house of the Lord, Marabaya, I know in the new covenant we are the house of the Lord. We're talking about the presence of God. So if you don't dwell in the presence of the Lord, how would you behold His beauty? How would you even know Jesus? How would He be revealed to you? This is David saying, say, one thing have I desired, that will I seek after. What are you desiring? The Lord is saying, this is the time to desire me. This is the time to desire. For I am doing a new thing in this era, in this dispensation, Karabaya, and I need you. I want vessels. I'm looking for vessels that I will pour myself into, my Karabaya, so they can reveal me on the earth, so they can fill the earth with my glory, Karabashanda. One thing have I desired, and that thing I will seek after, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, to behold the beauty of the Lord and to inquire in His temple, my God. To inquire in His temple, because the presence of God is a place of revelation. It's a place of joy. It's a place of peace. It's a place of empowerment. It's a place of knowing. It's a place of discovering. My God. It's also the place of breaking. It's a place of healing. It's a place of transformation and perfecting. The presence of God. He says, seek my presence. He said, church, seek my presence. There right now. Let your desire not be in the flesh right now. But let it be after the spirit. Let it be after me. Let it be my friend. Let it be me, Jesus. That's what he said to his church tonight. So he's calling us to be desperate. He's saying, even for those who are living, you say you're not desperate enough. He say you're not hungry. Matthew chapter 5 tells us that hunger and thirst after righteousness, for they shall be filled. The Lord is waiting to fill us. He's waiting to fill his church, his bride, with power. With the grace for this new era. Hey, don't miss it in the name of Jesus. Because you need that grace to carry you through this era. Through this decade, through this century, you need it. This is the time to be hungry, to be desperate, be more desperate. Our sister Sinai sang, Lord, I want more of you, more of you. This is the time to seek God and say, Father, I want more of you. This is the time to be desperate, to appear before the Lord in a dry and thirsty ground. In the wilderness, say, Father, where are you? Where are thou? He said, call unto me. I will answer you and show you great and mighty things that I know is not. He said, if you seek me with all your heart, you will find me. Jesus is looking for those who will seek him in this era so he can release himself upon them. Praise the Lord. So they can begin to walk in power on the earth. Can they begin to change things? Begin to change systems. Can they begin to fill the earth with the culture of heaven, with the culture of the kingdom of heaven? Hallelujah. That we begin to legislate his will on the earth, that his will will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Say, now is the time, my church. Arise in the name of Jesus. Do not be overtaken by events. Do not let the enemy put you in a disadvantaged position. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. So let your eye be single so your body can be full of light. Let your eye be single. Karabashaya. This is the time to be wise. Like the five wise virgins in Matthew chapter 5, chapter 25. Lebaro Shakai. This is the time to cry out tonight. Say, Holy Ghost, I need your fire. Marabaya Karabashaya. It's not the time to lament about disobey. Oh Lord, why this is that. No. This is the time to seek the presence of God. Of joy, and as his right hand pleasures forever. So his presence, Karabaya, those needs will be met. Nobody encounters God's presence and stays the same. Karabaya, see, except you were never there. Karabaya, head of the bush. So this is how God is calling his church to wait for him, to wait on him, to seek him, to chase after him, so he can pour himself on them and reveal to them Marabashandahaya, that which is his mind for the season, for this time. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Karabashandahaya. Lebarosha. So this is the time for you and I to begin to pray prayers like, rekindle my fire, Holy Spirit. Ignite me with your fire, Holy Spirit. Karabashaya. This is the time to begin to say, Holy Spirit, bring your fire. Hebeboshandahaya. I know I am hungry, but I want to be more hungry for you. They say a hungry man is an angry man. This is time to be angry in the spirit. Karabashaya. I say, Father, I need you more. Change things. I want to change things for your kingdom. I want to make impact on the earth. Karabashandahaya. One powerful general just left us a few days ago. The person of Evangelist Reinhard Bonnke. That was a great man of God. And we honor him. And we are grateful. We are not mourning because we know he's with the Lord. He has walked, he has served. He has fought the good fight of faith. And he's going to be with the Lord. Hallelujah. What are you and I doing? You and I still have a life on the earth. Because why? There's still purpose that needs to be fulfilled. And God is saying you cannot fulfill it when you're sleeping. When you're carried away. You cannot fulfill it when you are awake. So he said, you need my fire. This is how you should cry. Release your fire. Fire me up in the name of Jesus. Fill my lamp. This is the time to be awake. This is not the time to sleep. Say, wake up, church, in the name of Jesus. This is the time to shun the loss. This is the time to die to self. This is the time to shun destruction. This is the time to shun ungodly. Your gaze on Jesus, looking unto him, the author and finisher of your faith. This is the time to be serious. It calls for a serious moment. It calls for a sober reflection in the spirit of the things of God. Because time is ticking. The clock is ticking. Say, arise in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. So we're going to go into worship tonight. The nature of tonight's worship is for revival. It's to cry out to the Lord and say, Father, fill me with your fire to help me to stand. We can't stand on our own. We need the grace connect the Holy Spirit. And he's the one that comes with the fire. So this is the time to cry and say, Lord, revive me, Jesus. I know I've been sleeping. If you can be true to yourself, you know, you've been slumbering. This is the time to say, Holy Spirit, I acknowledge I've been sleeping. Come, Arabosha. Come and fill me, Jesus. Marabakora. Come and quicken me. Say, if that power that raised Jesus from the grave lives inside of you, will he not quicken your mortal body? This is the time we need the Holy Ghost more than ever. Arabosha. Because he's the one that will pioneer this move of God in you and I as vessels. Praise the Lord. This is time for us to be purified by his fire. This is time for his fire to come for separation, to separate us from the flesh, so that the Spirit can gain dominance and begin to dominion on the earth in the name of Jesus. Praise God. So right now, I just want you to open up your mouth. Today is not for prayer, because the one for prayer is every third Friday of every month. This is for worship. But as the Lord leads us today, we're going to flow. I just want you to pray this prayer and say, Lord Jesus, I know I've been sleeping, and I thank you for your word that has come to quicken me, to awaken me from my complacency. Hey, I can't help myself. I ask for grace. I ask that you ignite your fire in me. Can you open up your mouth and say, Holy Spirit, I ask you to come in the name of Jesus. Ignite in me your fire again. Fire me up again, Karabaya. Fire in me the passion for souls. To go out into the field and begin to speak to men about Jesus Christ. Begin to talk to the sinner, Karabashaya. Because I know when I do, you will move and you will convict the sinner, Sarabaya, and convert them and bring them to the kingdom. Say, Holy Spirit, inspire me again. Strengthen me again. Revive me again in the name of Jesus. Awaken me, Karabaya. Deliver me from the spirit of slumber in the name of Jesus. Karabaya, do not sleep the sleep of death in the name of Jesus. Do not be carried away by the festive season. There's something that is more important than that season. Souls. Karabaya. Remember the person we are celebrating, Jesus, even though he was not born on the 25th of December. But we are celebrating why? Because he came to die for souls. He came for you and I to save our souls from sin. So this is the time to be sober and begin to pray and intercede for souls, for men and women, and go out there, Karabashaya. Let that be your Christmas gift to any man you see on the street. Give them the gospel, give them Jesus, give them the Holy Ghost, give them the kingdom, Karabashaya. That's the most important gift you can ever give to anyone in this season. Karabashaya, in the name of Jesus. So just pray about the Holy Spirit, Karabashaya. Say, Lord, I'm desperate for you, Karabashaya. Put in me that fire of desperation. Let me be desperate for you, God, in the name of Jesus. You are calling me to come up higher, to come up thither. Lord, I ask for your help. Give me that fire. Fire me up in the name of, fill me in the name of, fill my lung with oil in the name of Jesus. Let me not be dry. Deliver me from dryness. Deliver me from barrenness. He said, except the Spirit of God come upon us from on high. Only then will the wilderness become a fruitful field. Hey, Lord, we need the Holy Ghost in the name of Jesus. So tonight, lift up your voice and begin to pray. Holy Ghost, Karabashanda. Hey, Lord, Shekarabashanda. Quicken me in the name of Jesus. Quicken me in the name of Jesus. Quicken my understanding, Karabaya. Make my understanding more fruitful. Quicken my body. Quicken me in the name of Jesus, Karabasha. To come alive to your will in the name of Jesus. Let me not be carried away. Let the enemy not cheat me. Hey, Rebo Shandahaya. Hey, by making me to sleep in the name of Jesus. Libarosia, Darosia, Deriamana Kosaya. Hey, Adanosia, Lord, it is me. Time to present yourself before the Lord. This is time to appear before the Lord. Let me say, when will I appear before the Lord? This is time the Lord is calling to appear before him, so that you and him can communicate, you and him can have fellowship, you and him can talk, can have a conversation. He can talk to you about things, about your life, your loved ones, your family, your ministry, whatever it is, and even about nations, even about people you don't know. Karabasha, this is the time the Lord is willing to release his secret to who he found faithful, who are willing to pay the price, who are willing to deny self in this season and seek him in truth. Father, I just thank you for your word in the name of Jesus. And I ask, oh God, that you feel the longing of our hearts tonight. Feel every genuine hunger tonight for your presence, for your glory, for your power. Hey, for your will on the earth. Feel that in the name of Jesus. Let there be no vacuums left. Let there be no spaces. Fill us tonight with your. Rabbi, revive your church. Revive the body of Christ in the name of Jesus. Revive us, oh God. Hey, give us understanding of those times and seasons. Hey, Lord, I will not miss the moment. We will not miss that which you're doing. We will not miss your new Father. In the name of Jesus. Cause us to be men and women of wisdom. Walking with the Holy Ghost. Walking in sync, in harmony, in tune. With your spirit in the name of Jesus. I ask that you impact us, Holy Ghost. So we can impact this generation. So we can impact the world. So we can bring back men to you. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. So I just want to lift up your voice and sing the song with me. by GUC that says desperate. Lord, it is me, the one that you saved, the one that you love. I have come. I'm desperate for you. I am desperate for you. Feel me in the name of Jesus. Knows how to feel you, Jesus. Your one is to ask, and ask sincerely from a place of truth and purity, and let him begin to do his work. Jesus. Hallelujah. Let me just turn up the volume of that song. We'll just listen to it once and we'll go to the next songs. We're going to play all the songs he wants us to play. Those songs are songs of prayer. The Lord. They are songs of hunger for the Lord. They are songs of longing for the Lord. So sing it in the name of Jesus. Open up your heart, your Holy Ghost. Here I am. I'm ready for your move. I'm ready for that which you want to do. I present myself. In the name of Jesus. Yes, God.
Who are you, Lord?
Father Mosha. God,
it is me.
Here I go.
God, it is me. I'm the one you sent. God, it is me.
Here we are, Jesus. Hey, I am desperate, Lord. My soul is crying out. Are you tired of your level? Are you tired? spirit? Are you tired of your growth? Are you tired of your hunger level? Are you want to increase it? This is the time. The Lord is ready with his fire to fill you and I. He said, call out to be desperate for my presence, for my power, for my glory. Press in, press in, press in. There is more, there is more in the name. Hey, Ananana Saya. Yes, God. Yes, Lord. Karabashada. I want personally, God. I want more Jesus. I want more Karabashaya. Hey, Mosaya. In those days, we're told that Peter and John were going to the beautiful, to the temple, and they met a beggar, a man that was lame, begging at the gate.
Press into his presence. Press into the presence of the Lord. Hey,
don't sing or romance it. This is the time to preach holiness and righteousness. This is the time to preach repentance at hand. Let every man be sober, be vigilant, and watch unto prayer. This is not the time to be playing on the fence. This is the time to end up your heart. This is the time to stand for Jesus. You end up for Jesus, you end up for Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. So I'll take us to the next song. Arabakaya, Karabaya, Nidarosia, and Abosha. Liba Osha, the Haya, Nidarosia, Kurabai, the Haya, the Bosha. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. 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 Karabaya, Sia, the Bosha. Libarosia, and Abosha. I just expect you to be crying and I say, Lord, I receive this word, I suffer this word, and I just ask you to help me. Help me, help me, help me, help me, help me. Bring your fire, Lord. Help me, Jesus. Energize me, strengthen me, quicken me, Jesus. Yes, Lord. This is the time to set your eye. Let Jesus be the only Lord. The only thing that matters to you. Let it be all that matters to you. This is the time to deny flesh, deny self. Separate yourself from this and go into be with the Lord.
I wouldn't trade.
We will not trade you, Lord. This is the time to declare your stand for the Lord. This is the time to declare, like I was supposed to say, that I may know him. That I crucified, I am of the fellowship of his suffering. This is the time. Is Jesus the love of your life? Is he the love of your life? Because where a man's treasure is, that's where his heart will be. This is the time the Lord is calling our hearts back to him. Calling our hearts back to him. Church is calling your heart back to him. Do not set your love on something else, but set it on Jesus. Treasures for yourself on the earth where cockroaches and insects and rodents will destroy them, but lay up treasure for yourself. This is the time to give your heart to the Lord, to set your heart. This is the time to make your eyes single, the author and finisher of our faith, of our salvation. The Lord, Father, I won't trade you for silver or gold. I won't trade you for materialism. I won't trade you for friendships. There are some friendships that you need to separate yourself from so you can go higher. Hey, do not let friendships, connection, affiliations make you lose the moment. This is the time where you need to end one certain bridges you need to burn and build up. It's a new era. It's a new season. Everyone must not go with you. Everyone must not like you. It's time to cut out, to cut away, and to cut off certain things. Certain things that don't certainly beset you. This is the time to do away with them and press in to know the Lord. You must travel. So this is the time to separate you, certain bandages, certain things that will stop steal your time or make you lose your fire. This is the time to separate from them. He's calling you on to separation. Only a man who is desperate will separate himself, because he's desperate for one thing, for the Lord. He wants to encounter him. He wants to know him. He wants to love him. He wants to be in constant fellowship with him. He wants to love him. He wants to know him. He wants to have a conversation with him. He wants to know his mind. He wants to share his burden with him. He wants to feel his pain with him. So this is the time not to trade the presence of God for anything. There's nothing like his presence. Nothing is as valuable or more valuable than the presence of God. And his presence is not common. His presence is not popular. That's why he gave me this mandate on popular worship. It's all about the breath of God. It's all about his presence. It's all about the Holy Ghost. It's not popular. What does that mean? It's sacred. It's holy. It's set apart. So if God is set apart, it is time for us, his body, his church, to be set apart. Hey, to begin to live the life, to begin to live the life of set apart. He said, come out from among them and be separate. This is the time, said, church, be separate unto me. Be unpopular. Stop being popular. Hey, I did not call you to be common. He said, well, for you, a chosen generation, a royal priesthood, a peculiar people. That is not common. That is an uncommon people. God is calling us to become an uncommon generation that will carry uncommon power and glory on the earth. It is only by that we can change situations. But when we are common, we can't change anything, because already we live in a society that is common. So you need your common to change things. So this will raise an army of an unpopular generation for the kingdom of God. Carrying the glory of God. His glory is not popular. It is sacred. It's holy. Catch this soon in the name of Jesus. Hey, Elohim, separate yourself. By me, and I pray the song blesses you. It's still in line with what God is saying to the church. Hey, Rebosha, he said, this is the time that he wants to fill the earth with the cry and say, Father, let your glory fill this place. Pray that the Lord fill me with your glory. Hallelujah. Jesus, you reign, you reign. Yes. Because the source must be like Christ. It must be Christ in them. Herebo Shanda. You cannot be like yourself or like Christ in all things.
Jesus, you are the glory of the Father. And no one, yes, oh God, no one compares to you.
Hey. He's trying to convey to us in this season. So I just want, you know, 5 minutes of your time. I know we're almost, time is almost up. I just want 5 minutes of your time for you and I to personally cry out to the Lord in worship and say, Lord,
send your fire.
To purify me, to be because His presence is a place of revelation. Let us send your fire, because His fire has the ability, the capacity, the power to keep you and I in His will. In His will. In His will. You cannot be cold. You cannot be cold anymore. You gotta be on fire. You gotta be hot for the Lord Jesus. You gotta be hot for the kingdom of darkness to see you, to hear your name and take up. You must carry that fire, that glory. This is the time to say, Lord, send your fire. I know I've been sleeping, but I'm waking me now with your fire. Send your fire to keep me, Lord, in your wing. Let's sing that song again. Come and say,
all the other names fade away. All the other names fade away.
to fade away with 2019. So you can come into the greater. So you can come into the new that the Lord has released in the spirit. What are those names? Mention them. Addictions, alcohol, lesbianism, homosexuality, perversion, sexual immorality, unrighteousness, uncleanness, bitterness, envy, jealousy, pride, arrogance. What are those names? Mention. And let them fade away. Prophesy over your life that they fade away right now by the power of the Holy Ghost in the name of Jesus. So that only Christ will be exalted in your life. Only He will be enthroned in your life. Only Christ will be seated in you, Jesus. Let all the
Celebration in Jesus' name.